Listen to this. This is music to the ears. Do your brakes drag or make squeaking noises? Front wheels with these symptoms can be very dangerous as they are the wheels responsible for steering. Rear wheels, on the other hand, are a bit less dangerous with similar symptoms as they are being driven. All these are clear signs that it is time to service your brake calipers. I'll show you how to do exactly that in this video. This video is part of a brake maintenance series and focuses on the rear caliper. This video is not a complete caliper rebuild, but a check, clean, lube maintenance. There are links up here for other brake maintenance videos to completely service your braking system. Water, salt, dust, dirt and brake pad material tend to combine and accumulate inside your bike's brake calipers with time. This fact inhibits their proper retracting action, and therefore brake pads continue to partially grip when you let go. That is because dirt or rust builds around the caliper piston exposed areas, not letting them to return all the way back. I must stress that this is only to be attempted if you have some prior advanced DIY mechanical experience and you use the right products, as brakes are a sensitive item. If you don't have this experience, please visit your local dealer for this task. If you decide to attempt this at your own risk, note that you will be working with the following: brake dust, metal particles, brake cleaner solvents, and other harmful chemicals like special greases and pastes. Now, some of this stuff are bad and some are good for brakes, but all, with no exception, are known to carry a range of serious health and safety risks when one is exposed. So safety first. Work on a well-ventilated area, use gloves, safety glasses, try not to inhale when cleaning with brake cleaner, and use a brush to apply the special greases and pastes. So let's put our safety glasses and gloves and let's begin. Okay, rear brake caliper. It is slightly different from the front brake calipers because it's a different brand, but it's also very different in terms of how much access we have to work, because in previous generations, the first generation for instance, it was very easy. You had a lot of access to work in this area. Now in this generation with this exhaust, it is really difficult, but I will show you how it's done. To service your front calipers, refer to my other video up here. Before we take the rear caliper off, we have to first undo this pad mounting pin, as with the caliper removed, it will be very hard to perform this task since the pin is very tight. First, remove the pin plug with a flat screwdriver. We will use a wrench with a socket that has a flat screwdriver. So unscrew the plug. So this is the small pin plug. Once the pin plug is removed, as you can see underneath, there is a pad mounting pin with an Allen head of size 5, and we have to loosen this now before we take the caliper off. We need to access and work with this Allen head bolt and this Allen head pin over here. And what the problem is that when we finish with our job, we're gonna have to tighten them to the specified torques, and especially in the case that you are not an advanced DIY mechanic, you need to use a torque wrench, because brakes are a sensitive item. You need to ensure that everything is tight properly. Now the problem is that if you buy an Allen head socket, it's too long. There is not enough room to use it in this area. An alternative is to create your own Allen head socket, which is shorter. You take a normal Allen key, you cut this side off, then depending on the size, this is a size 6, you take the same size socket, insert the Allen, and as you can see, you have your custom shorter length Allen head socket. So take your wrench with a socket, an Allen head socket of size 5, and undo the Allen head pin that holds the pads. Just loosen this up a bit. Next, undo this mounting bolt. You need a socket of size 12. Hold the pads with your fingers and pull the pin out. So as I mentioned, we left this second mounting Allen head bolt because this is the bolt where the caliper pivots on. By pivots I mean that it turns, as you can see, like this. Hold the brake pads, lift the caliper, remove the inner brake pad, remove the outer brake pad, and so far the process is exactly the same as when you need just to replace the brake pads with new ones. So you don't have to undo the second Allen head bolt, you just undo the pin and this first bolt, you lift and remove the brake pads and then put the new ones back. So now it's a good time to inspect your brake pads for wear patterns or whether or not they need to be replaced. To check if they need to be replaced, you check the grooved limit lines, these lines on the center. When this grooved line in the middle has almost disappeared, it means that it's time to replace your brake pads with new ones. And then the other thing that you need to inspect them for is for wear patterns. These wear patterns shown now on your screen. Consult on them and identify whether or not they have some weird pattern that indicates that there might be a problem with your caliper functioning. So passing on to our last mounting bolt. Again, we will use our custom-made Allen head socket of size 6 and our wrench. So insert your wrench with the Allen head socket and untight and remove the bolt. Okay, so now our caliper is free from mounting bolts and it is still held by the braking line, which is also clipped into this part and this part over here. First, release the brake line with the ABS, unclip it. Then unclip the other place back here. Next step is to remove these two Allen head bolts. Take your hex number 6. Remove the bolts by hand. remove this whole part. So lift the caliper carefully with a brake line. Be careful because it's sensitive. As you have noticed, once we have removed the caliper carefully, we have supported it on a low table or with the aid of a bungee cord, as the OEM brake lines are very sensitive. They are not made of steel, and so they cannot support the brake caliper weight. First, what we need to do is to expose the caliper piston gum line. In order to do this, I have reinserted the mounting, the brake pad mounting pin, temporarily, in order to have more access, additional access, to any dirt that might have found its way inside the caliper piston. So put your angle grinder discs, hold the brake pads, and then press gently the brake pedal to expose the caliper piston. This is something very important, because as you can see, any time that you push the pistons back, for example, when replacing the brake pads with new ones, you don't want to push with the brake pistons inside the pot. You don't want to push also the dirt and corrosion, because it will accumulate inside there and it will also damage the rubber seals. After this point, we enter the do not press, the brake pedal zone. Note that I have covered the various motorcycle areas well to protect them from brake cleaner. Take your pick tool and remove the brake pad spring. Just make a note, the large side, the greater length of this side goes from the caliper piston side. Push the metal sleeve from this side and remove it. Remove also the rubber boot. On the rear caliper carrier here, there is another rubber boot, so take this out. There's also another little seam that the pads rest on, so remove that as well. On the carrier seam base here, from this side and also from the inner side here, you usually, with time, you get a buildup of corrosion, brake dust, and some powder of brake dust and dirt together, so clean it, because this usually causes the brake pads to bind. Now it's the time for our brake pads. First, remove any brake dust accumulation around the brake pads with a flat screwdriver, like so, and also on the grooved limit line, like so. Remove the seam from the brake pad. On the rear caliper, we have a seam, this one, an insulator, this one, and the brake pad. So it's now a good time to inspect all the caliper components for damage or excessive wear. Check the caliper assembly for damage or leakage of brake fluid. Look for scoring or rust on the caliper pistons. Inspect the pad seams for good rebound movement, and for any cracks or deterioration
on the rubber boots. Our so far cleaned parts with hot soapy water, we will exclude the rubber boots and the insulators for the brake pads, and we will clean the rest of the parts with brake cleaner. Try and avoid spraying directly to the caliper piston. Continue with the smaller parts, the smaller components. This next step is optional, so use a silicone spray, not a silicone lubricant, but a silicone spray that waterproofs and protects metal and rubber. Put a clean paper towel from the inside and then spray to give a nice coating to your brake caliper. Repeat the same with the outer part of the rubber boots. This is the actual seam that is placed on the base of the caliper carrier. It grabs from the back with these two edges, and on the front part is where there are some stops and some edges where the rear caliper brake pads sit. On the back side of the seam there are two edges, this one and this one, and these are very important because they are bent deliberately so that this seam is secured and does not move. So if you see that yours is a bit loose, you can take a small pliers and just bend them as much as required to give a secure placement. Then when you place it, it's going to fit tightly, like so, and not move up and down, you see? Apply a high temperature silicone paste and insert it into this opening, spreading it around. This is the small rubber boot of these two sides. This one is the inner one. As before, apply some high temperature silicone paste inside, feed the inner side inside the opening, and then twist, pressing a bit, and it will grab. This is the large rubber boot. Again, take some high temperature silicone paste and insert it inside with a cotton bud. Place the large rubber boot, fold it like so, feed it inside and let it expand on itself. Passing on to the reassembly of the brake pads, there are patterns up here that will help you identify where to apply an extreme pressure, high temperature grease, specifically for brake pads. There are patterns depending on the number of openings that the brake pads have got from behind, from the backside. In my case it's two, so the application should be in the middle, just one dot in the middle. Apply just a small dot, take your brush and spread this a bit, removing also the excess grease. Then it's the insulator turn. It goes here. Repeat the same on the insulator. Then place the back plate or seam. Passing on to the second brake pad. Again, similarly, two openings on the back part of the brake pad, one dot in the middle. Apply the extreme pressure high temperature grease, spread it, insert the insulator, repeat the same process for the insulator, avoiding the opening. Take the back plate or seam, and insert it into position. Next in turn is the caliper piston. To lubricate the caliper piston, the manual states that you can do this with some brake fluid, DOT4, but there is an alternative, red rubber grease, which is also safe for the inner caliper piston seals, and it's also brake fluid compatible. Take a thin smear of red rubber grease and apply circularly around the caliper piston. Next, let's put back the brake pad spring. Long sides go from the inner side, from where the caliper piston is, and this edge. Next step is to reinsert the metal sleeve inside the rubber boot in this position. Take your high temperature silicone paste, apply some and work it around with your fingers. Then insert it slowly. Make sure that when you insert the metal sleeve, it's properly up against both rubber seals. Don't forget that we need to push the caliper piston back to its original position of when we took it out to clean it better. So take one of the brake pads, the inner one, it will have a circle here, place it like so and press evenly with your hands, and the caliper piston will slide back easily. Take your caliper, insert it back, place the brake line back into the clip, like so, and in the second part,
make sure that both lines are inserted inside here,
like so.
I have hung the brake caliper from a bungee cord now.
High temperature silicone paste on the smooth bottom part and copper grease on the threaded part.
So now we will put the first bolt, the one where the caliper pivots on. Note that in order for the bolt to start moving, it's best to have the caliper not pivoted but in the normal position, and then you can tighten the bolt. Once you find some resistance, stop, and we will insert now the brake pads. This is the outer brake pad. These parts come in contact, these metal parts, so I will put just a thin layer of our extreme pressure grease, which is exactly for this purpose. Pivot the caliper or lift it up and then place the brake pad here, like so. Same thing for our second and inner brake pad. Apply some extreme pressure, high temperature brake pad grease in the areas where the brake pad comes in contact with the seam. Similarly, insert the second brake pad, and in order to be able to do this, you might find that you need to push the brake caliper towards the inside so that the second inner brake pad has got room to sit properly. The mounting bolt on the left, we insert some high temperature silicone paste on the smooth area. Apply it or work it around with our fingers, and apply some copper grease on the threads. This part with the copper grease is okay because it will pass through the metal sleeve, so it will not affect the rubber boots. One trick to make sure that the brake pads are aligned and are into position before we put their mounting pin is to put this bolt . Use your brush and apply this properly. Then insert, assisting with the brake pad. Do the same from the other side. So the next step is to start tightening the bolts. So we take our custom-made socket with the Allen head. Both of them are of size 6. The specified torque is 27 Newton meters. Adjust your torque wrench and tie to the specified torque. Again, we take our custom Allen head socket of size 5, both of them 5, and we tie to the specified torque, which is 17 Newton meters. Next, it's our pin plug. We will apply copper grease to make it easier to take it off the next time. With a flat screwdriver head and a torque of 2.5 Newton meters, tight the pin plug. If you don't have a torque wrench, just snug it a bit, but do not over tight because it's going to be very difficult to remove it without damaging it. Next, it's this caliper mounting bolt. The socket is of size 12 and the torque is 22 Newton meters. Last but not least, we need to put back the footrest for the passenger. You need to apply some thread lock to these bolts. Apply some thread locker to the second bolt.
take your Allen head socket of size 6. When you find some resistance, just snug it a bit, quarter of a turn, that is. As always, thanks for watching and ride safe.